Hi there. I want to talk with you today about probability and chance. Probability, as you probably know, is a fraction. It's written as a fraction. It's the number of ways that an event can occur out of the total number of possibilities. Now, chance is very much related to probability. It is the probability of an event will occur, but it's written as a percent. So to find the kind of difference between those, let's just take a look at this example. Suppose we have these numbers in a box and we're going to draw them randomly from the box. So we want to say what is the probability that we draw a one? Well, the number of ways that the event can occur is three because there's three ones in the box, and the total number of possibilities is 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So the probability that we draw a 1 is 3 out of 8. Now, the chance that we draw a 1 is this probability, 3 out of 8, written as a percent. And if you remember how to write a fraction as a percent, I'm going to grab my calculator here, and we are going to take 3 divided by 8 to get our decimal. So it's 0.375 as a decimal. To turn a decimal to a percent, we have to multiply that by 100. So it will be 37.5%. So it has a 37.5% chance of drawing a one. Okay, so they're very much related. To find chance, you first of all have to find the probability. Once you find your probability of your event, then you can just turn your fraction into a decimal to determine the chance of your event. All right, now this idea of chance can be thought of in terms of a continuum, and just like probability also, can be thought of in terms of a continuum from a 0% chance of something happening up to a 100% chance of something happening. Now, a 0% chance of something happening means it will not happen. It is impossible. It cannot happen. So, an example of that, the probability that I draw a six out of this box here is zero because there is no six in the box. I can't do it. So that is an impossible event. I cannot draw a six out of a box that does not have a six in it. So it's got a probability of zero or a 0% chance. Now, something that is a 100% chance would be flipping a coin and getting a head when you have a two-headed coin. So that is something that has a probability of one or a 100% chance. So something that's a 100% chance, it is absolutely certain to happen. It will happen without a doubt. There's no possibility that it won't happen to be a 100% chance. Now, in between there, we have some things here, like if we go to the 50% spot, the way it's often worded is as likely as not. So something that has a 50% chance of happening is as likely to happen as it is to not happen. And then anything between 0 and 50% here, let me change colors of my pen. Anything here is unlikely to happen. And the closer it gets to 50%, the more likely it is to happen, obviously. The closer it gets to 0%, the more unlikely it is to happen. And here in between 50 and 100% are likely. So things are likely to happen when they're between 50 and 100%. So to just kind of review what we've talked about here, to find the chance of something happening, we first of all find the probability, And then once we find the probability, we turn that into a percent to find the chance of it. So let's come back with a couple of examples of this idea of impossible, unlikely, as likely as not, likely, certain, and then finding the chance of something happening. All right, so let's look at the situation of flipping a coin, let's say, three times. So if we flip this coin three times, let's first of all come up with the different probabilities. To do that, we have to know how many total possibilities we have. So I'm going to draw a tree diagram for that. Let me grab the pencil. So first flip, we can have a head or a tail. Second flip, we can also have a head or a tail. And then the last flip could also still be a head or a tail. So this tree diagram shows all of my possibilities of flipping a coin three times. I could have a head, a head, a head, a head, a tail, that's two possibilities, head, tail, tail, etc. So this last column, there's eight different things in it, there are eight different possibilities. So let's look at what is the probability that I flip and I get, let's say, one head. Okay, and that's exactly one head when I flip this. Okay, so we know already that the total number of possibilities is eight. And then we just have to look through our list and say, how many of those have exactly one head? Well, it's going to be when we have a head, tail, tail, there's one of those possibilities. Or when we have tail, tail, head, there's another possibility. So we have two out of eight for the probability. That reduces to 1/4 if we want to reduce it. And then we have the chance is 1 divided by 4 is 25% chance. So we have a 25% chance of flipping one head when we flip a coin three times. Okay, so in terms of our scale, well, it's 25%, so that is between 0 and 50%, that's the unlikely thing. So it's unlikely to flip a coin and have one head come up out of three flips. So it's unlikely to happen. So that's pretty much it with this lesson. Probability, you have a fraction. Chance, you turn your fraction into a percent. And then you have that continuum from 0% chance up to 100% chance, and the closer to zero, the less likely it is. The closer to 100, the more likely your event is to occur. Hope this helps straighten things out just a little bit. Have a great day.